Hey everyone, I'm LC Gamer, and welcome back to Sina Maria. The last level was a bit hectic, especially with all that spinning platforming that was making me kind of nauseous. So let's try and tuck that away for a second and move on to the next level or chapter. The epilogue. Huh.
They say wisdom comes with age. But as I get older, I've begun to feel the opposite is true. It's not that I know less, per se, although the pace at which I learn is certainly slowing. It's more that, as a child, I saw more and experienced more. Everything was new. I reveled in tastes. Colors prickled my senses. All sensory input made me feel richer. As I grew older, my world narrowed. Precise moods that I used to know in the past, I couldn't even begin to recall now. What brought me to this point? I don't know. I can no longer feel the purpose. The object, the sensation. Back then it was the journey that amazed me. Today, I'm pleased enough by simple arrivals. And I have arrived. This is Syriad, the home of the project, the floating fortress. Our story will end here.
Will it? Let's find out.
Akita Dryad, recording. This is the last circle. The Prophet Enki has seen nothing further for our nation. Whatever the Empire is up to, we will do everything in our power to try and prevent it. If all goes well, Linthus should be working to distract the Empire during their victory parade. We will make our stand. There are only two of us now. All other Enkis are dead, or slaves of the project. We cannot save them. There's simply nothing to be done. The book does not have our names written. Either both of us die, or whatever may be. Recording pause.
Go.
Code Red D. Movement in Central Corridor.
Oh, that could have been bad. Oh, somehow I'm alive.
Ow! Would you? Stop it!
Can't even see where you're coming from. You expect me to be able to survive this? Apparently they do. Let's try this again. Knock it off, would you? Nope. I'm going. Frick you. Thank you. hate this thing. Die already.
Die, bastard!
Get off of me! Freaking thing. I'm trying to save that. Where'd you go now? Thing, get off of me. Nope. Okay, I got a shield. Don't have a shield now. Just die already. Frick you. Stay still for a second.
Red F. Emergency shutdown. Life functions have ceased in all blocks.
No!
And now I'm dead. Alright. Oh, fan. Let's have a fight for the third time. It's you. Need all of that. Give it back. This ain't me anymore. Taking all my power ups and just shitting on me. Stay away from me. Unless you have a freaking power up for me, stay the hell away from me.
You freaking toad.
Code Red F. Emergency shutdown. Life functions have ceased in all blocks.
No!
I'm gonna run out of time before you even get done with all this. Oh! How would that... How'd I survive that? That should have killed me. That should have killed me.
How stable can history be when you can travel through time? The only thing you can count on is the state of the present moment, the status quo. According to the current state of things, on the day I killed my father, the terrorist in our registry, under the name of Akita Dryad, extinguished her own nation and vanished into time without a trace. So perfectly without a trace, one could presume she landed somewhere past the time continuum. I have no hope of ever saving my father, and the only one I could hope to seek revenge upon would be myself. All I'm left with is a sour irony. Dryad would perhaps tell the story with greater indifference than I do. It took me a long time to notice it. Her time and trials are not yet over, but she certainly paid her dues for her country. The sensors on Syriad recorded an intrusion of two foreign beings that day. Deep analysis of the sequence of events that caused her to obliterate her people has become a matter of imperial interest, since the key to Lael's power and riches lies with the project. But that's a different story for another time.
Huh. And that was... Cinna Maria, apparently. And oh my lord, that final boss was a pain in the ass. Killed me too many times. Well, good gameplay. The narration was great. The story each one was trying to tell was a little muddled, because telling a story through time travel is always get things muddled very easily. You have to be very careful in writing a script around it. Oh well. Music was good. The whole the clock is your life thing was a little annoying there at the very end, but overall, good game. And if you guys like shoot 'em ups or bullet hells like this, give it a try. See if you can do better than I did. Alright. Well, I think I'm going to leave it here for now, and I'll see you guys in the next video when we go to the next game. So until then, see you guys. Or maybe I'll check out some of the special features. Who knows?